Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for coming for last lecture for today. You have power. And what we'll see today? First of all, I will give an overview of OpenID Connect, and I will describe the protocol, and will show how it's compared to other protocols. I will review a couple of implementations, and finally, I will show the best OpenID Connect implementation from Kiklu. Before I will start, a couple of words about me and the company I work for. I have a lot of years in development, and as most of you, I do like application security. I start to work more than 10 years in this year, and I enjoy every day that I work in this area. Last couple of years, I work as lead security architect in Tufin, and I am responsible for application security of all Tufin products. Something personal, I do like to travel, I do like to read books, to listen to music, especially jazz. And now a couple of words about Tufin. It's a great company. And it's already 12 years old, our bar mitzvah next year. So, in addition, we have a lot of customers, big customers, small customers, customers in every industry. For example, AT&T, Visa, BMW, our customers. We always growing. When I came to the company, we took about 1.5 floor in the building. Now we take about 4 floors. And it's only in Israel. We also expand. We recently opened We recently opened a new main office in Boston. Okay, we are always looking for good people, and you can open the link and you see we are looking for people in R&D, sales, marketing, every area. And now about OpenID Connect. Our customers have very strong demand in security. They have a lot of features requests. For example, they want password policy. For example, they want root source protection. They want authentication with Kerberos. They want authentication with SAML. About 1 year ago, we have choice. We have required to select between options to develop this in-house or to adopt something, some product. I recommend to adopt OpenID Connect, and you will see during this lecture why I recommend it and what we benefit from this protocol. This protocol is based on OWASP2. It used REST and GWT messages. It's simple and extendable protocol. Maybe you visit the first lecture today. Omer described one scenario when he adopted OpenID Connect. Okay. In addition to Omer company, many big companies, many big vendors adopted OpenID Connect. You can take, if you will adopt OpenID Connect, you will be able to authenticate your application against these vendors. You will be able to authenticate against Google, against Microsoft, Yahoo, PayPal, and the list of companies that provide OpenID Connect Pro is growing. Now, for example, you can find Symantec or other companies. Okay. What components we have in OpenID Connect? First of all, is identity provider. This component that authenticate users. And reliant party is companies that just want to use authentication with identity provider. In our case, in case of Tufin, Reliant Party was our product that use web, have web UI interface, and we In case of your company, it's maybe some Android application or whatever. Okay, here is our components. This is a reliant party, identity provider and user. Let's start authentication flow. First of all, user access request, and the reliant party redirect request to identity provider. Identity provider just provide the login page. Please understand that this is example of form authentication. In case of form authentication, user will see login page. In case of other type of authentication, user will not see a login page. For example, Kerberos, it will be seamless authentication. IDP will authenticate user, and the user will not see it, login page. Let's continue our example. User need to provide credentials. Identity provider authenticate user and redirect request back to reliant party, to IP. RP access to IDP via REST API and get user information. User information also called identity ID token, identity token, and this it's concrete username and additional user attributes. Okay, I present you flow called authorization flow. It's flows is quite commonly used. We use it in a traditional web application where we have channel from RP backend channel from RP to IDP. There is additional flow, implicit flow that I will not show. In case the identity information about user is provided with the last request to RP. Okay? When you can use it, when you have application, for example, only JavaScript application, JavaScript cannot access via back channel to IDP. Okay. Finally, RP create authentication, create user session and resource. User can see the resource in the browser. Okay. How many people knows XAML? How many people know XAML? Great. When I show slides, do you feel that it's something that you know? Do you see that the flow look, what this, can you describe? Can you tell me what this flow is? SP initiated flow of XAML is exactly as implicit flow of OpenID Connect. You see, we have very similar flow. OpenID Connect used very similar flow, but so why OpenID Connect and not XAML? Let's compare OpenID Connect to additional protocols. Okay, first of all, let's start from XAML. XAML is very known and old protocol. XAML 1 was introduced in 2002, and XAML 2, additional version of XAML 1, was introduced in 2005. It's high rate of adoptions. We have requirements from many customers. We want XAML authentication and XAML authentication. Many enterprise customers use XAML. So, but it's use XML messages. OpenID Connect uses JSON REST messages. What's the benefit? The package size, the total package size used for the total authentication flow is decreased. This is very, and also, if you want to develop single sign-on for mobile application, you will not be able to do with XAML. Okay? OpenID with OpenID Connect. In the morning session, they use OpenID Connect and not OpenID and OpenID Connect different protocols. OpenID Connect is first protocol designed by OpenID Foundation. You see that even they have very similar icons, logos, sorry, OpenID, and just have here OpenID Connect. What's the difference? OpenID Connect uses XML and some custom signatures. Okay? And the OpenID Connect, sorry. OpenID Connect uses GWT. GWT is standard and it allows you to create interoperable application. Okay. And let's compare the last protocol, it's OWASP2. Who thinks that OWASP2 is authentication protocol? It's good. Who thinks it's authorization protocol? Great. OWASP2 was developed to this protocol to give application access to resource. It's somehow called like pseudo authentication, but it's only authorization protocol. So we cannot use this protocol for authentication. On the other side, it's good framework, it's good protocol, and you can use it. So you can take authentication, but you can take identity, you can take those two, combine together, you have OpenID Connect. OpenID Connect uses those two flows and scan, and we have good protocol for authentication. Okay? Ladies and gentlemen, we compared, we finished our overview. Now you may ask a question, Michael, what's our next step? We want to adopt OpenID Connect, we want to deliver in the next sprint. What we should do? My answer will be simple. You need to select your relying party, then you need to select your identity provider, and you will complete your OpenID Connect adoption. Where you can take your relying party? Here you have a big list on the OpenID Connect. OpenID Connect Foundation has good process of certifications, and you can find certified relying party libraries in this list. It depends on your language, on your technology, of your application, of your client. For example, if your client uses PHP, you can use PHP relying party. If your application run behind Apache HTTPD, then you can use relying party of Apache HTTPD. Identity provider. When you take and adopt relying party in your application, you need to authenticate against some IDP. You can authenticate against IDP, for example, against public IDP that I provided at the beginning of the lecture. Also, you can do it, you just take some of IDP provided in this list and use it. You can take Glue Server, you can take Mitre ID Connect, you can take Keycloak, okay? Now, at Tufin, we selected Keycloak. Couple of reasons. First of all, it's open source, okay? Second, we need OM solution. We want to move our authentication to some component and to finish to develop our authentication. It continuously, it rapidly developed. Also, Red Hat support Keycloak. Red Hat is a very good company, and its commercial product Red Hat SSO is based on Keycloak. What's interesting, I will show it to you. If we will try to access any page in Red Hat site that requires authentication, okay, Then finally, I will show you something interesting. Okay. Let's take time. Yeah, I will. Do you see the cycle? Did you see it today? Okay, it's last lecture, it's probably tired. It's up here, exactly here. It's Kiklok logo. When I adopt for Kiklok in Red Hat, so they use it for single sign-on, they forget to change the title icon. Please don't tell it to Red Hat. I will need to use it in next presentation, so don't tell it. Okay, let's continue. Kiklok IDP. Kiklok IDP is based on Whitefly, JBoss, maybe you remember. It's if you need to configure some feature like server administration or clustering, it's you will do it in a very similar way like in Wi-Fi. Okay. I will show now the Kiklok UI. I will not be able to show every feature, but I will show a couple of important features. Okay. Okay. Let's go. Admin and password. You can record it, the 1111. What we have here? You have here real configuration. You can configure here users. Okay, you can add users. You can add its groups and roles. Here you can see every authentication event. It's audit trail of Kiklok internal, user login, user logout. Here you can configure identity provider. Kiklok can be breached to external identity provider. If you want your application will be authenticated against some OpenID Connect provider, just add it here. If you want to connect it against some provider, you add it here. I mean, if you take your applications and once you adopt OpenID Connect and adopt it against Kiklok, it's like a bridge to any SAML or OpenID provider in the world. In addition, you can already, they have built-in social identity provider like Stack Overflow. Okay? If you like Stack Overflow, you can authenticate your user against Stack Overflow. Okay, back to the presentation. ARPI, they have very long list of adapters. It's their name of ARPI. And if you select Kiklok, you can choose this one of adapters, one of ARPI. Just open this link. And once again, I need somehow to close presentation and the link to things. And I will show in a couple of minutes. Now I will show the second. Okay. Here, list of Java adapters. You can see Spring Boot, Spring Security, Jazz plugin. I take example from Spring Security. Who knows what Spring Security? Great. Spring Security also great framework for Java. I enjoy to use it, and I just take one example. It's called like Spring Security tutorial. Just name I download it. I used the instruction I showed you before. This a configuration file. I configure it. In Keycloak, I need to configure applications. Okay, it's clients. They call it client. They have built-in clients for daily Keycloak use, but I have added sample one and sample two. What's most important when I configure clients, it's client ID and client secret. Okay, the same client ID and client secret appear here. Okay, this is secret, and this is client ID. Now I have two Tomcats. I just configured to run on different ports, and I especially take two Tomcats to show you that two separate applications without some hidden Tomcat SSO, but two separate applications. Okay. Now I will access the first application. I will always use second private. Private window, okay, sample one. You see now it's redirected to Keycloak. This is Tomcat, first Tomcat, second Tomcat, and this is identity provider Keycloak. And you see that it's redirected for the Keycloak URL. This is the same login page we see before. Let's authenticate using the same user. And you can see authenticated. I will close it and will open the second application. Just you will see that it is protected. Okay. I can access to application or only after Keycloak authentication. Now I will add some user called B or Bob, let's say Bob. I will add password also. Okay, and now what I do, I will now I access the first application. I will authenticate this user Bob. And now I will open the second application. People, what do I say? Single sign-on between two applications. Okay, let's continue our journey. Couple of advanced Keycloak features. Somebody don't know what is brute force protection? Okay, great. Just I put it this slide because I was happy to find something from OWASP. All previous links not from OWASP, this link from OWASP. And I just edited this link to add the link from OWASP. And what we have in Keycloak? Keycloak has two kind of brute force protections. One protection is against automation attack, and second type of protection against manual attacker, manual attacks. Okay, maybe you will tell me that, wow, it's not our customers required something in addition. Okay, but at least Keycloak provides some kind of brute force attack. Okay, that you don't need to develop. And I will show it to you. Once again, I need to close this view. I go to git log. How can I do it? Very simple. I come here, brute force protection, enable. Two clicks, and my application protected against brute force protection attack. Okay. To demo it to you, with your permission, I will change max failure from 30 to 3. Otherwise, it will be difficult to show it to you. Okay. I will use the same user, you. Okay. Shows it's still possible. Bob, wrong password. First, second, third. Now I will try to use correct password. I cannot log in. Okay. This is the reason. Can you see it, by the way?
Yes.
Users, why? User template disabled. By the way, it's good from the security point of view that we don't show it to user. Authentication failed. I don't want to show to user that, oh, your account is temporarily disabled. But I can, as administrator, I can go to users and unlock all users. Where is this? I can log in. Okay. Additional feature, password policy. What's password policy? A set of requirements or rules. User follows these rules and application owner, administrator can ensure that the user password is strong. I was not able to find any definition on OWASP page, so I wrote my own. I hope it's clear. What Keycloak can provide. Keycloak have very long support of policy types. You can define minimal digit. You can tell the password should contain 2 digits. You can tell that password will expire in 3 days. I will show it. First of all, I will show the link, and then I will provide the real demo. Policy is password. Okay. Lowercase character, special character, not username. Great feature. One additional feature, not recently used. History. I know it's from. Also, I need in my company. We use password policy for Windows. And I used my own techniques with counter, with some numbers, because it's very difficult to remember it. But from the security point of view, it's very easy and very good. Let's see how can I do it. Once again, I go to configuration. With your permission, I first will disable brute force protection. It's disabled only by one click. Now I want to configure password policy. surprise with a password policy. Let's define a one digit. Let's define a one uppercase, for example. And what else? Minimum length, let's say 3. You can, by the way, 55. By then your user will kill you, but you can configure it easier. 3, save. Now what I will do, I will add additional user. Let's say Alice. And I will provide I will enforce user to change password after first authentication. Okay, this. Need to provide password. Alice don't know that she need to provide password with some policy. Okay, she will try one and one, at least one uppercase. Okay, let's try uppercase. Now I understand she needs 3 characters, okay. Okay. What do you say? Also simple. It's simple and last slide. Summary. If what we learn from lecture, if your business not authentication, you can adopt, you are most welcome to adopt OpenID Connect. It allows you to enforce strong authentication scheme. It allows you immediate support for advanced features like brute force protection, password policy, or another features. It also will allow to leverage additional IDP enhancement in the future. You don't need to develop it. Okay? And at this point of time, I want to thank you for your time, for your pause, and you can contact me if you have any question or you want to send resume. Thank you.